Facts to know. What is stroke? A stroke, also known as a brain attack, occurs when a blood vessel that carries oxygen and nutrients to the brain is either blocked by a clot or ruptures. When blood flow to the brain stops, the brain cells in the area begin to die. The brain is an extremely complex organ that controls various body functions. If a stroke occurs and blood flow can't reach the region that controls a particular body function, that part of the body won't work as it should. Acting fast can make a big difference for someone who's having a stroke. The National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke emphasizes that getting emergency help within an hour can prevent long-term disability or death. According to American Heart Association and American Stroke Association, people who are treated with a blood clot dissolving drug within 4.5 hours of symptoms have a greater chance of recovering without major disability. Some strokes may also require surgical treatment. The ability to recognize the signs and symptoms of a stroke can mean the difference between life and death. Stroke symptoms are unique because they come on suddenly, without warning. The National Stroke Association suggests using the term FAST to help you recognize common stroke symptoms. F for face. If you notice a droop or uneven smile on a person's face, this is a warning sign. A for arms. Arm numbness or weakness can be a warning sign. You can ask the person to raise their arms if you're unsure. It's a warning sign if the arm drops down or isn't steady. S for speech difficulty. Ask the person to repeat something. Slurred speech can indicate that the person is having a stroke. T for time. If someone is experiencing stroke symptoms, it's time to act fast. Additional symptoms of stroke may include vision problems in one or both eyes. You may suddenly have blurred or blackened vision in one or both eyes, or you may see double. Headache. A sudden, severe headache, which may be accompanied by vomiting, dizziness or altered consciousness, may indicate that you're having a stroke. Trouble walking. You may stumble or lose your balance. You may also have sudden dizziness or a loss of coordination. Numbness in limbs, most likely on one side. Overall fatigue. If you feel these signs yourself, or see them affecting someone else, call your local emergency services. Women can have unique stroke symptoms. These symptoms can also happen suddenly and include fainting, general weakness, shortness of breath, confusion or unresponsiveness, sudden behavioral change, irritation, hallucination, nausea or vomiting, pain, seizures, hiccups. Maybe their face is drooping, but they can still walk and talk fine, and there's no weakness in their arms or legs. In a situation like this, it's still important to act fast if there's any chance you're seeing the warning signs of a stroke. Speedy treatment can improve chances for full recovery. Call your local emergency services or get the person to a hospital right away. According to the American Stroke Association, you don't have to exhibit all of the warning signs to be having a stroke. After you call emergency services, check to see what time you first noticed the warning signs. The emergency crew can use this information to help determine the most helpful type of treatment. Certain types of medicine need to be administered within 3 to 4.5 hours of stroke symptoms to help prevent disability or death. According to the American Heart Association and American Stroke Association guidelines, people who are experiencing stroke symptoms have a 24-hour window to receive treatment with mechanical clot removal. This treatment is also known as a mechanical thrombectomy. So remember to think fast, act quickly, and get emergency help if you notice any stroke warning signs. You can prepare for stroke if you know you are at risk for one. These steps include educating family and friends about FAST, keeping your updated medical history on hand, having emergency contacts listed on your phone, keeping a copy of your medications with you, teaching your children how to call for help, knowing the address of the hospital in your area that has a designated stroke center, if one with a center is available, is helpful. Types of stroke. There are three types of stroke. 1. Ischemic stroke. An ischemic stroke is a blockage in the artery. This is the most common type of stroke. It happens when the brain's blood vessels become narrowed or blocked, causing severely reduced blood flow to the brain, ischemia. blocked or narrow blood vessels are caused by fatty deposits that build up in blood vessels, or by blood clots or other debris that travel through your bloodstream and lodge in the blood vessels in your brain. 2. Hemorrhagic stroke. A hemorrhagic stroke is caused by a blood vessel leakage or rupture in your brain. Brain hemorrhages can result from many conditions that affect your blood vessels. Factors related to hemorrhagic stroke include uncontrolled high blood pressure, overtreatment with blood thinners and anticoagulants, bulges at weak spots in your blood vessel walls, aneurysms, trauma such as a car accident, protein deposits in blood vessel walls that lead to weakness in the vessel wall, cerebral amyloid angiopathy, ischemic stroke leading to hemorrhage. A less common cause of bleeding in the brain is the rupture of an abnormal tangle of thin-walled blood vessel, arteriovenous malformation. 3. Transient ischemic attack, TIA. A transient ischemic attack, TIA, also known as mini stroke, is a temporary blockage in the artery. A mini stroke or TIA don't cause permanent damage, but they do increase your risk for stroke. They're caused by a temporary decrease in blood supply to part of your brain, which may last as little as 5 minutes. Seek emergency care, even if you think you've had a TIA, because your symptoms got better. It's not possible to tell if you're having a stroke or TIA based only on your symptoms. If you've had a TIA, it means you may have a partially blocked or narrowed artery leading to your brain. Having a TIA increases your risk of having a full-blown stroke later. People who recover from stroke may experience these effects: weakness and paralysis, spasticity, changes in senses, memory, attention, or perception problems, depression, fatigue, vision problems, behavior changes. Your doctor can recommend treatment for these symptoms. Some alternative treatments like acupuncture and yoga may help with concerns such as muscle weakness and depression. It's important to follow through with your treatment after a stroke. After having one stroke, your risk for having another stroke increases. Talk to your doctor if you have a health condition or other medical factors that increase your risk. They'll be able to work with you to manage risk factors. Risk factors of stroke. Many factors can increase your risk of stroke. Potentially treatable stroke risk factors include lifestyle risk factors such as being overweight or obese, physical inactivity, heavy or binge drinking, use of illegal drugs such as cocaine and methamphetamine. Medical risk factors: high blood pressure, cigarette smoking or secondhand smoke exposure, high cholesterol, diabetes, obstructive sleep apnea, cardiovascular disease, including heart failure, heart defects, heart infection or abnormal heart rhythm, such as atrial fibrillation, personal or family history of stroke, heart attack, or transient ischemic attack. Other factors associated with a higher risk of stroke include age. People age 55 or older have a higher risk of stroke than do younger people. The older you are, the more likely you are to have a stroke. Sex. As we get older, our risk of stroke increases. Although men are at higher risk of stroke, women suffer from stroke much later in age, making them more prone to die from stroke. Hormones. Use of birth control pills or hormone therapies that include estrogen increases risk of stroke. A stroke can sometimes cause temporary or permanent disabilities, depending on how long the brain lacks the flow of blood and which part was affected. Complications of stroke may include paralysis or loss of muscle movement. You may become paralyzed on one side of your body or lose control of certain muscles, such as those on one side of your face or one arm. Difficulty talking or swallowing. A stroke might affect control of the muscles in your mouth and throat, making it difficult for you to talk clearly, swallow, or eat. You also may have difficulty with language, including speaking or understanding speech, reading, or writing. Memory loss or thinking difficulties. Many people who have had strokes experience some memory loss. Others may have difficulty thinking, reasoning, making judgments, and understanding concepts. Emotional problems. People who have had strokes may have more difficulty controlling their emotions, or they may develop depression. Pain, numbness or unusual sensation. Pain, numbness or other unusual sensations may occur in the parts of the body affected by stroke. For example, if a stroke causes you to lose feeling in your left arm, you may develop an uncomfortable tingling sensation in that arm. Changes in behavior and self-care ability. People who have had strokes may become more withdrawn. They may need help with grooming and daily chores. Prevention of stroke. Having a stroke increases your risk for another one. The best treatment for a stroke is prevention. Many stroke prevention strategies are the same as strategies to prevent heart disease. In general, healthy lifestyle recommendations include controlling high blood pressure, hypertension. This is one of the most important things you can do to reduce your stroke risk. If you've had a stroke, lowering your blood pressure can help prevent a subsequent TIA or stroke. Healthy lifestyle changes and medications are often used to treat high blood pressure. Lowering cholesterol and saturated fat. Lowering the amount of cholesterol and saturated fat in your diet can help to reduce your risk of stroke. Eating less cholesterol and fat, especially saturated fat and trans fats, may reduce the buildup in your arteries. If you can't control your cholesterol through dietary changes alone, your doctor may prescribe a cholesterol-lowering medication. Quitting tobacco use. Smoking raises the risk of stroke for smokers and non-smokers exposed to secondhand smoke. Quitting tobacco use reduces your risk of stroke. Managing diabetes. Diet, exercise and losing weight can help you keep your blood sugar in a healthy range and reduces the risk of a stroke. If lifestyle factors don't seem to be enough to control your diabetes, your doctor may prescribe diabetes medication. Maintaining a healthy weight. Being overweight contributes to other stroke risk factors, such as high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, and diabetes. So maintaining a healthy weight helps to reduce the risk of stroke. Eating healthy diets. A diet containing 5 or more daily servings of fruits or vegetables may reduce your risk of stroke. The Mediterranean diet, which emphasizes olive oil, fruit, nuts, vegetables, and whole grains, may be helpful. Exercising regularly. Aerobic exercise reduces your risk of stroke in many ways. Exercising regularly can lower your blood pressure, increase your levels of good cholesterol, and improve the overall health of your blood vessels and heart. It also helps you lose weight, control diabetes, and reduce stress. Gradually work up to at least 30 minutes of moderate physical activity, such as walking, jogging, swimming, or bicycling, on most, if not all, days of the week. Drinking alcohol in moderation. Heavy alcohol consumption increases your risk of high blood pressure, ischemic strokes, and hemorrhagic strokes. Alcohol may also interact with other drugs you're taking. However, drinking small to moderate amounts of alcohol, such as one drink a day, may help prevent ischemic stroke and decrease your blood's clotting tendency. Talk to your doctor about what's appropriate for you. Treating obstructive sleep apnea. Your doctor may recommend a sleep study if you have symptoms of obstructive sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea is a sleep disorder that causes you to stop breathing for short periods, repeatedly during sleep. Treatment for obstructive sleep apnea includes a device that delivers positive airway pressure through a mask to keep your airway open while you sleep. Avoiding illegal drugs. Certain street drugs such as cocaine and methamphetamine are established risk factors for a TIA or a stroke. Preventive medications. If you've had an ischemic stroke or TIA, your doctor may recommend medications to help reduce your risk of having another stroke. These include antiplatelet drugs. Platelets are cells in your blood that form clots. Antiplatelet drugs make these cells less sticky and less likely to clot. The most commonly used antiplatelet medication is aspirin. Your doctor can help you determine the right dose of aspirin for you. Your doctor might also consider prescribing Agranox, a combination of low-dose aspirin and the antiplatelet drug dipyridamole, to reduce the risk of blood clotting. After a TIA or minor stroke, your doctor may give you aspirin and an antiplatelet drug such as clopidogrel for a period of time to reduce the risk of another stroke. If you can't take aspirin, your doctor may prescribe clopidogrel alone. Anticoagulants. These drugs reduce blood clotting. Heparin is fast-acting anticoagulant drug and may be used short-term in the hospital. Slower-acting anticoagulant drug, warfarin, may be used over a longer term. Warfarin is a powerful blood-thinning drug, so you will need to take it exactly as directed and watch for side effects. You will also need to have regular blood tests to monitor warfarin's effects. Several newer blood thinning medications, anticoagulants, are available for preventing strokes in people who have a high risk. These medications include dabigatran, rivaroxaban, apixaban, and edoxaban. They are shorter acting than warfarin and usually don't require regular blood tests or monitoring by your doctor. These drugs are also associated with a lower risk of bleeding complications, so knowing the risk factors and taking preventive measures for stroke is necessary for your overall well-being. Thanks for watching the video. For more update to my new videos, press the bell icon, and please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to support my channel. Thank you.